We're paying strangers to draw a beast from Revelation's Bible prophecy. Let's see how they're gonna take on this creative challenge. This will be a lot of fun. Wow.
That is mind-blowing, seriously.
That is really, wow.
On the website Fiverr, we're going to select random professional artists and give each of them the description from the Bible and see what they come up with. At the end of the video, we would judge the results based on three criteria: creativity, skill, and accuracy. But we are not only going to judge their art.
We want to thank Whitehorse Media for partnering with us and giving us the budget to hire the artists. I will tell you more about them later in the video.
I will draw a character design for $5. That's within the budget.
That's cheap. Wow. That is for the sketch. Yeah. And here it says that it is for one figure. So we want two figures, because that's the Bible prophecy about. So $10. Let's see what he's going to come up with in the sketch.
I will create stunning flat illustrations for you. I'm curious for how do you make this beast as a flat one?
She has good reviews. 82 reviews, 5-star rating, $10. That's good.
I will make any illustration and concept art that you need. That picture with the dog, that's what we are after. And also like the face of that woman, the hair, the details in that.
We can do this one if you can pronounce the name.
Nico Gutierrezar.
$90, there we go. I will create amazing fantasy illustration. Look at that. Look at the detail.
I really love it.
This will be our most expensive one. 105. I have high hopes.
Now that we have hired the professionals, we thought it would be fun to see what complete amateurs would be able to make in only 2 hours. So yeah, that would be us.
So we're doing this for your entertainment, guys. Don't judge us, okay?
We are gonna judge us.
Right. Yeah, you don't. We're gonna judge ourselves. My drawing skills are...
You know how Photoshop works, at least. I don't know how any of this works.
Time for an in-depth Photoshop masterclass to get Katja ready for the difficult task ahead. So here's the brush, and yeah, that's it. And done. Now that Katja is also a Photoshop expert, it's time for an important decision. Who's gonna start?
I don't know.
I think I know a good challenge, but here, hold him.
Do you also want to paint, Delina? Ah, maybe we can see what you come up with. Oh, whoops. Doing something.
So, I have here two puzzles from Eliane. You have that one? I do this one?
Whoever I think that one is easier.
No excuses now then. Whoever finishes first gets to decide. 1, 2, 3. What is a good strategy here?
I don't know. Just put them in.
You're almost done. Ah, I need to speed it up.
Oh, ah, baby! Yes!
Oh, no.
That was close! I was so eager to try it, so
well,
I want to start.
2 hours. Here's the description from Revelation 17. Come, I will show you the judgment of the great harlot who sits on many waters, with whom the kings of the earth committed fornication, and the inhabitants of the earth were made drunk with the wine of her fornication. And I saw a woman sitting on a scarlet beast, which was full of names of blasphemy, having 7 heads and 10 horns. The woman was arrayed in purple and scarlet, and adorned with gold and precious stones and pearls, having in her hand a golden cup full of abominations and the filthiness of her fornication. And on her forehead a name was written: Mystery Babylon the Great, the mother of harlots and of the abominations of the earth.
I don't even know what I'm thinking when I hear this. Of course, like a woman sitting on that beast. That's like the only picture I have in my head. I might start with the background. I think this is gonna be really tricky. 2 hours starting now. I'm sitting here when I'm painting, laughing in my head because this is just so bad. This is just embarrassing. Stop it! Stop it! Oh.
2 hours starting now. Looks like a duck. Oh, I feel, don't even know what to say. Now that we've finished our masterpieces, it's time to reveal the results. But before we do, I want to tell you something about White Horse Media. They are a Christian media ministry with a lot of cool resources that you might like. They have different articles on their website, courses, YouTube videos specialized in current events and Bible prophecy, but also practical things like how to leave the cities if you want to live in the countryside. And they have just released a book about the prophecy that the artists have drawn in this video. So check out the links in the description if you want to check them out for yourself. All right, so now it is judgment time. We're gonna judge all the pieces and we're gonna start with us.
I'm so ashamed.
I mean, it's... That one head looks good.
I kind of did that in the end, and then I discovered like, oh, okay, this is how you can do a bit. But I didn't have time for any of the other heads.
Hey, but I like your detail with the kings of the earth.
Fornication and with the kings of the earth.
So I'm gonna score yours, and that one is gonna count double so that you don't need to score your own. Mm-hmm. I think creativity with the kings of the earth and the hearts and that you made the world in the cup. I would give it an 8.
Really?
Creativity. Yeah.
That's not bad.
Accuracy. It has 10 horns. Almost the colors not. Are right. Golden cup. You have jewelry. It sits on waters. Yeah, I would say it's very biblically accurate. Like those details are in there. I would give that an 8. Then skill. With in mind the potential of this, I know how hard painting with color is, and I gave up on that. I would give it a 5. Doubling these scores brings Katja to a total of 42 points. What is she gonna give me?
Yeah,
let's go to mine now. Oh, this is gonna be a test for our relationship. There we go.
Oh, that is nice, babe. But there is no colors.
I tried to color it in, but they looked like pigs in masks. It was terrible.
I would have been very curious to see how it would have looked in colors. I think it's very nice, babe. I'm positively surprised.
Okay, cool. Creativity.
Well, you have not like put anything, any background. You have not put anything like where does it stand? It's in the air. Way, even if I think like the beast in the head, you did really good, but with the creativity, maybe a 4.
Okay, comment below. Is that fair? That's so, a tough judge. And then accuracy.
7.5 skill. I am positively surprised. Well, I think it's very skillful with those heads and all the angles. 5.5.
Okay.
Because it's not color. I can't get away from like that. It is easier to make it in a sketch than we color.
And that is very true. And it brings my total score to 34. And now we're gonna look at the professionals and see what they did. And we're gonna start with the cheapest one and we go to the most expensive. But we got in one additional artwork. We were in the process of seeing what artists to hire. And then someone sent us this artwork, this sketch.
That is a really good sketch.
Wow.
It reminds a lot about yours. Like, but yeah.
This is the good version.
The upgraded.
Wow.
That's very nice. Yeah. With our scores, Behance Graphics comes to a total of 43.5 points. Let's look at the sketch from SBS Illustration. Very interesting.
$10.
Wow, I like the movement to it. That she's sitting like so calmly in the middle of all those heads.
It's looking like one you can color in.
Yeah. I really like the flow to it, the movement, and all those tongues.
This sketch from SBS Illustration gets from us 45 points. Now, Bondarukiana.
That is interesting.
Again, it has all those elements, golden cup, the jewelry, the seven heads and ten horns, colors are right.
Yeah, with the abominations in the cup that you can see that it is something dark in it. I think the dress is very skillfully made for being a flat illustration, and yeah, the legs, I thought that was really hard.
The leg is a bit, it's a bit of a fat leg, or?
No, it's not a one leg, it's two legs, babe.
Aha! Now I see.
You thought it was one
Yeah, I thought
leg.
The left side was the shadow. I'm like, that's a pretty big leg, but in its style, it's good. But of course, compared to this others, it looks a bit different.
Woof woof. Yeah. Do you think it's a dog, Ellie and I?
Yeah.
This flat illustration from Wanda Rukiana comes to 41 points. And up next is the $90 artwork from Nico Gutierrez art. Wow!
Wow!
That is mind-blowing, seriously.
That is really... Wow.
This is, yeah, so many details. The ground is looking amazing, like the heads, all the teeth and the horns, that they are so integrated.
And look at the attention of detail, like the upside down cross around her neck. This takes it to another level.
When I read, like I remember saying that, oh, I don't know even what I'm thinking when I'm reading, but this would be what I'm thinking when reading it.
Okay, so let's rate this. Creativity, I give it a 9.
I give it a 9.
Okay, and then accuracy. You don't really see how many horns. The horns aren't that clear as in the others.
Nah,
and it's the cup. Is it a golden cup?
It's more like a glass, a normal glass.
I would give it a 7.
Yeah, I think me too.
But then skill, I give it a 10.
Yeah, 10 definitely, without doubt.
With a double 10 on the scoreboard, Nico Gutierrez comes to a whopping 52 points. Is that possible to beat for Vinero?
That is very different from the other ones, but wow.
Very different technique.
That's very interesting that they can be so different. I love those clouds. And
I love a lot about this.
Up
whoa, you can even see like, it has like fur.
Look at the woman, look at their face. Like that with the shadows and everything, that is very well made. Yep. And the cup with the light.
Oh man.
That is nice.
Look at the amount of detail in this one. Okay, creativity.
Yeah, I like the movement in it.
I also like that it has a foreground. Just those few pieces of grass create more depth.
Yeah, the depth is very good in it.
And the type of clothing to put on her.
Yeah, exactly.
That's creative. I give this a 10 actually.
Yeah, I would give it a 9.
Then accuracy.
I like that it's both like scarlet and purple on her clothes. Because that's something that I don't think anyone else had that actually.
No.
But I would give it a 9.
I'll also give it a 9. And then finally, skill. Again, 10.
Yeah, I'm gonna give it a 10.
With a near perfect score of 57 points, Vinero's artwork ends this exciting challenge, which we hope inspired you to see how you can use your gifts for God in creative ways.
Yeah, thank you to everyone who has been drawing to this. It was very nice to see your skills. Yeah, we can see that you're all good at what you're doing.
We will see you in this video or the one over there, whichever one you want. Make sure to subscribe. See ya. Maranatha.
Bye.